Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Empire of Angels 4. Okay, so just before we go ahead and jump into this Monshurmanni Village, I think that's how it's pronounced, I might be butchering that, but never mind. I want to just double check how everybody's doing. I haven't done any more level grinding off camera. Okay, so Naya's level 21, Leona's 21, so is Kefir, Christy, Ash was level 20, Freya's level 20, Teresa's level 21. How did you get to level 21 above everybody else? I don't know. Fran's level 16 and Shinma's level 18, so we're going to need to boost the two of them up. Have we actually upgraded them? No, we haven't. Okay. So at the moment you're just a plain archer. What's better for you actually? Should I change you to somebody else? Because I feel like we've got quite a lot of archers, but then again we kind of need quite a lot of backup, don't we? Right. I might just change you to a striker. A stalker. Okay, we're going to change you to a stalker just so we can boost up your attack a bit more, more than anything. So, confirm. Right, we'll skip that because we've already seen the transformations for this type so far. Okay, so you're done. Let's change over to Shinma. Now, what did you have originally? You had healing. We've already got two healers in our party just now, so I don't think we need a third unless we get more characters down the line, but the looks of it we might do because there's like seven more spaces up there. Yeah, I'm going to change you over to a sorcerer because I do want that dark implosion skill. So I think that's the best thing for us here. So let's go ahead and confirm you as well. We'll just change you as well. I've already seen the transformation for you as too before. Okay. Right, so they're now both upgraded. Still got a way to go before we hit the next rank so we can upgrade everybody again. We're only at 50. So I've got quite a few more battles to go to we reach that 130 there. Let's jump into my pet just now. I haven't really got much else. This is what we started with Lulu when she only had the normal attack there. Obviously I did some level grinding off camera the last time and I must have sort of defeated a boss level grinding in one of the areas to acquire this. I think he was a chaos or corruption or something like that. And he also has now the dark implosion skill, which is why I've been using it. There are a few sort of creatures here that I'd like to sort of get the abilities for. Mostly this sort of magma walker, just because it has high HP there. And I feel like sort of fireball plus and frenzy might kind of do some decent damage. But if I manage to unlock any of them, I'll show you that all the next time. We'd sort of find another level grinding area possibly. But other than that, I think we're pretty much done, aren't we? Atlas, I've not really looked at. Ah, okay. I've now got these three here. I didn't realise we had some of them. Do we have any more? No. Okay. Let's have a very quick look at these then, because I haven't really looked at them. Just going to very quickly skim them. Obviously, you guys can pause it if you want to read more on that. Kefir. Alright, seems like that's all we've got in Atlas, so let's go ahead now and enter this village and see what's going on.
Hola. la.
Ooh, la la la.
Ah, they're like getting angry. They said they're going to catch us all. Huh? How are you talking to them? Oh, no.
Right, so negotiations didn't exactly go as planned there. Right, let's just get everybody on our team just now. Alright, so I kind of get Shinma on there. I might take Franny off just because she's level 16 at the moment. And I kind of really want to put Shinma on there just for that dark imposing skill. Right, let's look at our battle info. Easy, defeat Tatasha or the Dory. Hard, reach the secret location. Condition reward, defeat less than 3 enemies, no ally, retreats from battle. Right. Now there's quite a few enemies there, so how am I I'm only supposed to defeat less than 3? I don't know. Right, let's just kind of start battling around. We'll have a very quick little look around here. Right, let's have a quick little look around. Right, so we've got some Monshurmanni, Monshurmanni villagers. We'll just call them villagers because I'm going to butcher this all the time. Right, so the villagers have 294 HP, 120 MP, and there's treasure chests over there. Right, 2 treasure chests. Oh, okay, so these are locked chests, so I'm going to have to open these then, so they're not the standard ones. Got 2 more villagers blocking that, so 2 treasure chests there. Anything else? That's nothing. There's villagers. More villagers. Right, what's this? Right, just some ceramic pots. Right, you're Tatasha, you're level 18, you've got 748 HP, 120 MP. And the Dory's level 18 as well. 730 HP, 120 MP. Okay. What's that? Is that light over there? Right. I wonder if that's that secret location I'm supposed to get to for hard. I'm not sure. I'm not sure how I'm going to do this, really. Alright. Don't see anything else. I don't see other treasure chests or anything like other than those 2 that were in this corner. Alright, let's start the battle then. First, I'm going to need to put... Who had the key thing? Was it Astrid or Kefir? Was it Astrid? Yes, it was. Okay, so it's, Astrid's got the lock thing, I'm sure. Yep, there she is there. So let's move her down here. And she's going to need some backup, so let's move Frida down here, and you're gonna need a healer at least to join you so you can heal up after battle. That means everybody else can kind of come down here. I feel like I just kind of want to defeat the enemies rather than trying to sort of, if I'm supposed to go all the way over here, because if I don't kill anybody, everybody's gonna kind of kill me, and I don't really want to do that. So I'm gonna move everybody up, and I'm just gonna just go ahead and start attacking. We'll take the easy way, but I'd rather kind of do that so we can try and get as much experience as possible. I'm not sure if we go for the harder setting to get more HP or not, but I'm going with this way. Seems like it's just going to be quicker overall. There we go. Right, what's one of them out of the way? Second one gone. If they go down that quickly, it should be pretty simple. I'm wondering then if that's why that's the easy way to sort of get rid of either one of them, because they don't have, they're sort of kind of soft, I guess. And obviously harder means that you're going to have to try and get through everybody to get there, so. Right, let's start with the people on the right hand side, seeing as they've got a bit of a job to do. hopefully those two enemies will come out now, seeing they're a bit closer to those treasure chests. Don't think I can do anything from here for anybody. Nope, okay, so we'll move you in the front. Just push everybody up. Yeah, that's good. We're going down pretty quickly, so that works for me. Just tidy your health up a little bit. Just cause you never know. One sliver of health could mean life and death. Oh, I need to actually summon. Forgot all about that, that you were actually there. If I actually just move you there, they might just come for Lulu. Means I can use some dark implosions and just try and help get rid of some of them. Okay. You hit a wee bit hard. Yeah, okay. So you hit hard just as much as we do. Right, again, we'll start from the right hand side. We'll move you up. We should be able to get a Fang Barrage. I don't really use it very often, but in this case, it's suitable. Get both of yous with us. Just take yous out. Did I get both? Yes, I did. Yeah, that's good. That means now I can move you over. Right, now we need to try and get rid of some of these guys now. It's a shame you're kind of spaced one out, because if you were kind of standing together, I could have took care of yous all. One hit, but sadly that wasn't the given for us. Right, so if I move up 1, 2, I might be able to get both of them. Alright, it wasn't as strong as I thought it was going to be, but oh well. I don't mind if Lulu dies, I'll just get her cast elsewhere. Now, ideally I'd rather she survived, but I'm not too fussed. I could probably heal her up anyway from here. Grip heal. She's the only one that needs healed anyway. There we go, that's another one taken care of. Should now mean everybody starts kind of sort of going towards us here. Oh, why did you heal her? Come on. I'm trying to kill yous on yous are healing everybody. Right, you've come down to play now. Right, first let's try and get these treasure chests. Hopefully something good's in them. Just seems like we got coins there, but we can start moving you guys back now. It's probably going to be a bit late by the time you guys get there, but just heal you guys up. There we go. Right, so you're kind of still a wee bit away, which means we should probably try and take care of as many of these enemies while we're just standing there. If I move Leona in the middle there, she can hit both of them there. Sword dance. There we go. You should be able to just take care of this. There we go. It's all coming to plan now. Nobody really needs a heal, so I can just use an arrow on you. Might need to move a bit closer. There we go. Right. Can't really do a spread shot, can't really do a spin attack. Could probably do a dark. No, a spike would probably do for you. I just don't want you healing anybody else up, to be honest with you. Ooh, nearly. Right, you're probably going to heal either yourself up or that other person, that knight. Aww. Right, so we're just going to have to go ahead and take you out this next round then, because I'll kind of be bored with everybody just healing themselves up here. We're going to have to go after... Who is that? Is that the Dory or something? Yeah, it's the Dory. Okay. So let's grab this other treasure chest quickly then. See what's in here. More coins, sadly. Right, we'll just move you over. You're probably not going to get in battle, but you never know. Right, so let's go and start attacking the Dory then. Alright. Let's hope it's going to be a bit better than that, but it wasn't. I'm going to have to move you, but I don't think I can do anything with you. So... I'll move you there. Do another sword dance, please. Start getting you into battle now. Right, at least that healer's out of the way. Nobody really needs a heal where I am, but I'm probably better not moving you so close, to be honest with you. Try and get rid of this other enemy. It's just a bit clearer. Right, we're getting there. I think we've gotten nearly halfway down. So we can try and sort of get rid of her before everybody else starts coming down, should be okay. Why are you moving away? Alright, you're healing them up. As long as they don't heal you, it's fine. Oh, you're coming down to play now. You leave her alone. Right, let's try and get rid of her now before this other one comes down. Is it Tatasha or something like that? Fifty-four to go, we should have this. There we go. Yeah, I probably wouldn't really bother too much going for the hard way, because there's no way if you want to try and defeat three enemies, then try and go for that hard way that you're really going to come unscathed, but... Right, we've got 2,082 gold and 10 more merits.
Jutta，啊，是波波可大巫师，那事情就好办多了。大巫师，他明明只是个小鬼。别看他的外形像个孩子，他的岁数恐怕比你我都还来得大。哎，你们这几个没礼貌的家伙，别随便在老人家面前谈论年纪呀，嘎噜！ 波波可大巫师，咱们也算有段时间没见面了。哼，你这个麻烦精，族里正在进行巨灵试炼仪式的准备工作，没时间跟你玩，快滚吧，嘎噜！嗯，你们又是谁？
大巫师您好，我们来自瓦尔克利王国，我叫尼雅，请多指教。瓦尔克利？
那个喜欢挑起纷争的国家吗？这里不欢迎你们，快回去吧，嘎噜。他们是我找来可以打败巨灵的勇士哦，这次是专程要来挑战的。<笑>嗯，你说你带来了可以打败巨灵的勇士，嘎噜。刚刚看你们与我族战士之间的交手，的确是颇有架势。 但巨灵的实力可远远不止如此。请问您能不能告诉我们有关于巨灵的事情？我们这里有一处巨石环绕的圣地，在很久以前，我族先人便认为里头具有一种神圣之气，而巨灵就是借由这股神圣之气孕育而生。 在我族历史中，从未有人能够活着从圣地回来，但我们始终相信，能与这灵搏斗是一种至高荣耀。所以每隔一段时间，族里就会选拔出几位勇士到圣地里向巨灵挑战。不过，从来没有外族人要求挑战巨灵。你们如果想要一试，就必须向祖灵请示。嘎噜，祖灵。没错，想挑战巨灵的话，就随我来。嘎噜。我将向祖灵请示，倘若祖灵有所回应，你们就可以进入圣地挑战。
你们看，你们的祖灵有回应了，他一定是赞同要让我们进入圣地里挑战传说中的巨灵。
想不到这么神奇，身为一名炼金士，随身带个几瓶助燃剂也是理所当然的嘛。你这么做未免也太冒险了吧？反正我们的目的就是要找到大地之石的下落嘛，不冒点险怎么行呢？你认为他们所说的巨灵跟大地之石有关？这个嘛，我想到时候就会知道了。
准备好了吗？我们该出发前往圣地了。
米米米拉，米米米拉。
他好像是在说有件紧急的事情，好像是什么人有危险。
他最要好的大姐姐塔塔莎，不久前独自闯进圣地里挑战巨灵了，嘎鲁。他原本就是这一次的挑战者之一，或许是因为不想输给擅自跑来缴获的外来者吧。
可是他只有一个人。
山猎族向来只厌恶怯战之人，如果塔塔莎在这一次挑战中牺牲了，那也是他的选择，甘露。
如果是这样，大巫师应该不需要特地前来告诉我们吧。
各位，我们走吧。
嘟噜噜嘟噜嘟噜噜，
这丫头也想救她的同伴呢。
一起来吧，多多利。
普救命！当啷！
Right, so it says the Dory's joined us, so let's have a quick little look at her. Right, so she's level 20, so that saves me having to level her up a little bit. She's got the fireball and she's another healer, but I can change her then. Let's think. We've still got two healers, so again, we could also use another person to use some Dark Implosion, so I feel like it may be better just keep getting people to use that skill, to be honest with you. So right, we're going to make her another sorcerer, so let's go ahead and confirm that then out. Again, as I say, I've got already healers on our team, so we don't need to keep putting many of them on. Right, okay, so other than that, I think that's pretty much it. So we're now going to have to go over these, I think it's Holy Grounds. Yep, and we're going to try and go and save Tatasha. So, let's go.
这里好像有什么东西。
该不会就是山里村民所说的巨灵吧？
我也不清楚，但我感觉这是一股古老又坚定的力量，并且正一直呼唤着我。
叽叽呀呀，叽叽呀呀。
别担心，我们一定会救出你的同伴的。
乌米，乌米达！
巨灵要现身了. Right, let's see.
So the Dorian Tatasha are already on our team here, so that's fine. So let's get everybody else on. So we need Kefir for a heal. Christy we need for summons. Astrid, we probably don't need to bother with Astrid right now. I mean, she opens locks, but I'm not really going to bother too much with treasure chests, I don't think. Frida we'll probably need. Teresa, we've got another heal, so that works for me. Now, I do want to get Shinma on my team, so I'm going to have to get rid of somebody, I think. Kind of need my both heals. I kind of need the two of them, so I'm probably going to have to get rid of Frida, sadly, and keep Shinma on there, but I kind of want to keep as many Dark Implosions as possible. Seems like the best skill that I've came across so far, so let's confirm. Right, battle info, what we got? Defeat the Djinn. Reward conditions, no allied troops in battle, defeat 12 or more enemies and claim all chests. I'm not going to bother with the chests, to be honest with you. So, alright, let's just go ahead. Right, what have we got? Right, so there's the Tasha, so it's fine, she's not too far in front of us. So what do we have? So, Templar Gargoyle, 334 HP, 150 MP, are they all the same? Yep, okay, so seem like they're all the same. What's these things? Alright, it's a snake, it's just kind of dark where it's sitting. So that's a Templar Guardian, 308 HP, 120 MP. You're the same, but you're 290, 120 MP, so you're slightly different. Anything else? There's one there as well. And there's two of them. There's a treasure chest there. Good news, I don't need the open skill to open it, so that's fine. If I decide to get them, I will. One over the other side? Yep, okay, so it seems like it's a grid that's all the same. So I've got these ones again, gargoyles. Okay, so we've got two gargoyles and a snake each end. Two gargoyles, two snakes at either end. And this is our djinn. It's a level 20, it's 824 HP and 150 MP. So, alright, let's just kind of start moving ourselves up here then. So we kind of need to start making a grid. Can't really hit anybody from here, but okay. Up the right hand side, we'll just sort of split our party up the middle. Kinda need a healer here. Let's got another healer here. We'll have Shinma in the middle just for a dark implosion. Dodori, you've got dark implosion as well now, so you can kinda go to the left. Tasha, you're kind of just standard attack really, so you can just go over and hit this so you can actually reach. And you actually do pretty decent damage to it. So you can kind of go on the right hand side there, Christy. And right, we need to summon, get Lulu on the field here, so she can kind of go up a little bit. Right, anybody going to come towards us? Oh, why did you heal? Come on. Aha, you missed. And I did a bit of damage to you. Well, that's quite an uneventful little round for us, but I could be able to do Dark Imposing on both of them, maybe. Nah, still a bit spaced out. Nice. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Damn. Can I go back? No. Like I said, yes, I can. Okay, that's fine. I didn't mean to do that there. I accidentally pressed the space and I was kind of wanting to do that. That's the good thing about that. You can't actually go back if you screw up. I haven't done it before yet, but I noticed that when I was level green, I could actually go back and do it. Actually, I could move there and use Fang Barrage. No, I can't. Yes, I can. No, I can. I don't know. I'm just going to have to do a standard attack. I thought I could do that with that, unless it's specific people that can only do it like that. There we go. One of them's down anyway, so if I move you over, I should hopefully get the other one. It's got a little bit of HP left. Nobody's really needing a heal from here, so I'm going ahead and get this other snake. Let's try and work our way up the middle. We should be able to finish this gargoyle off. There we go. Right. You should be able to go up the middle here as well. Attack the snake. Oh, that's a pretty decent hit there. Right. Oops, I keep forgetting. Should be able to hit you from here. There we go. Right, that's one snake done. I'm just going to keep going up the middle here. And get them to come out a bit. Okay, you hit a little bit hard there. We kind of hit a little bit harder as well. Right, so we now need to go and go save Lulu. Can't really do Dark Imposing for anybody really there. Keeping rid of this snake. Oh, it's only five left. Come on, you should have been able to kill that. You're gonna have to just move up. That's the only thing I can really do with you for the moment. I can't really do anything else, so... Nope. Stand by. And I'll need to move you up first, actually. Just so that we can get in a couple of spaces and then we'll be able to take care of the snake. There we go. We'll just heal Lulu up. I don't really need to, because I can always just summon her back, but I'd rather just keep her on the field just now. Okay. Lulu's turn. And ground spikes. Okay, it wasn't really super effective that, sadly. Thought it would do a bit better, at least kill. Oh, come on. What is it with all the heals now, man? We're all dying, no problem at the start of the game. These are all just more interested in healing each other up. It's not the way this works. Oh, right, these things spawn again, these snakes, which means I'm kind of pointless with going for them then, aren't I? Right, we're just going to have to do this then. Just gonna have to kill all these gargoyles. Hopefully these things don't spawn back at all. These things spawn battles, so aren't going to be a pain. Can't really hit you, which means I'm going to have to group heal a little bit. So we've got, what, two gargoyles left. We're doing okay. Tatasha kind of needs a bit of a heal, but she should be alright. Oh, come on, you healed again. Shouldn't really call them Templar gargoyles, you just call them healing gargoyles if that's all they're gonna do. Right, so that snake came back, but no other gargoyles have came back yet, so. Wait, what do I need to do here? I need to move Lulu out the way. Because I wanna move, oops, I did that again. I need to stop doing that. It's annoying when I try and press a button there. Right, I need to move you back down. Use dark implosion on you. Then I need to move Naya in the middle. So I can try and use this sword dance on both of them. There we go. Change now, we can go there. Attack that one. So that means now all the gargoyles have been taken care of, so let's start moving everybody up into position here to start taking on this Djinn. I want to kind of spread everybody out a little bit as well, so nobody's kind of all standing together. I just need to watch, I don't start getting these other snakes to start coming out here. Because I don't know exactly what skills this Djinn has, I don't want to move everybody too close together. Come on, Djinn. That's it. Thought for a second that you weren't going to come down. Right, that kind of looks like a group sort of attack there, but maybe it might be more line attack. Not sure, but let's get our team going here. So you can kind of go, let's see, there. Attack. Okay, we're doing no bad attack damage wise. Let's attack you there. You can make me space out a little bit. There we go. And you could probably do it, I'm going to be honest with you, but we'll go with it. We'll maybe need to heal you up. Okay, you only did 19, so you kind of suck a little bit. Move you there, and let's heal you up. And you can kind of move about here, possibly. Next to her. Hopefully you're not going to do anything bad to us. So, it's not really very effective. Try ground spikes. Closer. Okay. Not really effective, sadly. Ice spikes, maybe. Nah, okay. So, mobility's sort of down a little bit. Just move you over here. Now these, sadly, snakes are going to be kind of on our way now. Okay, watch for that. And you just healed yourself up. That's brilliant. Is this all you're really going to do is just heal yourself up? Does that mean I've now got to just kind of go all out at you in one attack? Because if you're just going to keep healing yourself up, it's going to be quite tricky to get rid of you this way. Seems like that's what we're going to have to do. Hopefully I don't get anybody killed while doing this. Come on, I need stronger attacks, people. You did absolutely nothing there, so I'm doing something wrong with you. People need healed, unfortunately, so I'm not probably going to be able to do all this. One hit, I'm going to have to try and get your health right down though. Star Composure really wasn't doing anything. Okay, you did 100 that time, so more than you did the last time. Didn't seem like it was very effective against you. Yeah, like that, it's not really doing very much. So hopefully you don't just go and heal yourself again, or we're gonna be here all day. Yeah, you're just gonna keep healing, aren't you? Okay. So I'm going to have to keep trying to sort of get your health down to the point of where you're not going to be able to top yourself up all the time. So let's just keep doing dark and close and so forth to pay off. See, if you keep hitting like 99s, it's not a problem. Yeah, you're doing absolutely nothing to him there, so you're kind of just wasted turn, really. Kind of take the turn and actually get both of us healed up here. And that was a good hit. You're down 148, which means if you heal yourself up again, you should be kind of round about halfway. Okay. Yep, so you're still going down, but we need to kind of do a bit more. Basically doing nothing really, so I may as well just go and attack a friggin' snake with you, really. Sword dance do something better? Okay, it's 108, so at least that was a bit better view hit. Let's try this. Oh, that was an even better hit there. We might have a chance this time around. 31. Still crap, but okay. Can you do the same bit? Good hit with a light damage. Come on. No, I was hoping you'd do better. Two good dark composures here to end this. Lulu, it's all up to you. Come on. We only have at least 48 to get that off here. There we go. Okay, so Seems like that is the case. You just basically have to keep attacking all the way out. It's going to heal itself up. You keep attacking it as best you can. It's going to take at least about 2 or 3 good sort of turns to really sort of bring it down if it keeps healing itself up. But we got there and we got 1,779 gold and another 10 minutes.
难道那就是女神圣物？我感觉到的那股沉静的力量，似乎就是源自于她。 圣物的传说果然是真的，真是叫人太激动了。也许真的能收集齐所有的女神圣物呢。到时候如果把它们全都卖掉的话，哎，不不不，怎么可能卖掉呢？那可是身为一名炼金师所梦寐以求的传说之物呢。喂，星马，那东西就是你说的什么大地之石吗？
哦，就我的研究，从石头的外观和色泽来看，应该是八九不离十吧。哼，讨厌的家伙，真是一点礼貌都没有。不过，如果要再找出其他的圣物，恐怕还得继续依赖他们了。星马呀，星马，你可真是有够坏的呢。 那么，大地之石就交给科菲尔，大地之石就交给你来保管吧。嗯，我会好好保管的。对，就交给科菲尔保管最适当了。
So we finally managed to get ourselves the first piece of the goddess artifact. Was it Menhir or something it was called? I'm really not sure what it said there. But okay, where are we going to next? Rainbow Cliffs. Alright, so we're probably going to do this place in the next episode. It did say Tatasha joined our crew there, so I'll try a quick look. So she's level 20 at the moment. She's infantry, but she's got a normal attack and spinning slash. So I kind of want to try and change her up a little bit. So which way do we want to go here? 155 attack as a warrior, and which is going to be about a knight. 116. Maybe if we change her into a warrior, possibly. Yeah, why not? All right, let's advance our class to that. So let's pay the 500. There we go, got ourselves another little warrior. It means then if we end up getting any more people, we can change them over to sort of knights if possible, because we've still got another couple of spaces there. That's fine. I just want to check the whole game for a pet for that. Nope, okay, we didn't. It's just because I saw that Djinn picture there and I thought maybe if we defeated that boss it would allow us to have access to this, but sadly not. Looks like it's just going to be a doing some level grinding bosses at some point to where I can get that, but okay. So as I say, guys, I'm going to leave it here for today. My computer keeps kind of flashing up that it wants to do an update, and I don't want it to delete anything I've done so far. So in the next episode, guys, we'll jump into the Rainbow Cliffs. So thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all again next time.